بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد الرجل على دين خليله فلينظر أحدكم من يخالل. A person will be on the religion, on the deen of his friend. So be cautious, be very careful whose company. Who do you spend your time with? As parents, we need to be very careful. We need to be very cautious, be very particular. Number one, physical company, friends, relatives, etc. Who do our kids spend time with? Secondly, online. Technology is a friend now, and that friend has many, many, many consequences. So we have to be very careful and cautious. And number three, the child is in your company. So as a parent, your mindset, your ethics, your principles will have an effect and rub off on the child. Likewise, your connection with Allah Jalla Jalaluhu will also rub off on the child. So part of training children is our own training and our own discipline. A parent's life is a lecture for the child. So we can speak volumes, but our actions speak libraries. So it's important that we make effort, spend time in the company of the ulama, the sulaha, the mashayikh, the allahs, the friends of Allah, the sadiqeen, the salihin, so that our tarbiyah is made, and in conjunction and concurrently, that will be a means of reformation for our children as well. So simple things, whether it's deen-wise, whether it's dunya-wise, bad habits, deen-wise, going last minute to the masjid. Why are we not there earlier? Why do we not read our nawafil without haste, without rush? There's no need to rush to the masjid. So that already is instilling a negative sentiment. Likewise, bad habits, simple thing like not wearing a seat belt or wearing a seat belt when we see the policeman, there's a roadblock. Some people have the bad habit of keeping their seat belt on the seat, and when they get into the vehicle, they put the top part over their shoulders so it seems like they've got a seat belt on. Likewise, some people have seat belt clips because there's a noise to deter a person from not wearing a seat belt. So that deterrent is there, so you do wear a seat belt. So people have these clips, ready-made clips, so that they can drive without seat belts. So this itself is inculcating a bad habit, and it stems out from the parents. So the mindset of our children to create the men of Allah, the rijal of Allah, will be the flag bearers of deen and Islam, and anything that will be a barrier for this, whether it will be impeding our performance of executing the command of Allah, we need to protect our children from that. Why? Because the mindset needs to be inculcated that deen is beneficial for the whole of humanity. Islam is the greatest need for mankind. When alcohol is made prohibited, when gambling is prohibited, when drugs are prohibited, these are instruments of destruction. And Islam has come with a solution, construction. And worse than that is the devastation that lies when a person passes away and goes into the grave. The destruction, if a person has not reformed themselves, has not recognized Allah, has not understood their purpose of life. And this is not only for the people of Iman, but every disbeliever, every idol worshipper. The people of Iman have been sent for their guidance. Whether it's that thief, whether it's that murderer, whether it's that oppressor, We have been sent for the guidance, for the benefit of humanity. This mindset of being selected, of being designated, of being nominated by Allah, this mindset needs to be imprinted in the minds of our children. Why? Because then their living has a purpose. It's a greater purpose. And what greater purpose on earth can there be to save the whole of humanity from the temporary torments and destruction of this world, and saving humanity from the permanent torment and trials and tribulations that lies after death? So this is a noble purpose and priority. And this mindset will come is when we primarily, the people of Iman, have this mindset. This mindset will now be transmitted and it will permeate the mindset of our children. And for generations, we've been sent for the benefit of mankind. Now, the different ideologies that is out there to destroy Islam, for example, amongst the most severest azabs, which not only one punishment came, but combined azabs, firstly torpedoes from the skies, which had the people's names on it, Musawwama, those torpedoes and missiles that Allah sent from the sky, pebbles and rocks, which had the names of the perpetrators of the Qawme Lut. So the people of Lut were engaged in homosexuality. But not only that adab, if ulama say, Mufassirin explain, if somebody from the people of Lut was traveling somewhere else on earth, those missiles hit them as well. Then, besides that, another adab where Jibreel alayhi salam came and he took that ground of earth and smashed it and destroyed, means their corpses, their bodies were really, whatever was left of their bodies, but to show the destructive nature. Now, punishment is there not for punishment. So when a teacher, when a headmaster takes a child to task, by nature he doesn't want to punish them, he doesn't want to harm the child at all. The purpose behind punishment is to set a lesson, to set a standard, to create, to imbibe the concept that this wrong that I've done is consequential. And this is a small punishment. وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains the small punishments are there for the greater punishments, that warning you that if this punishment can come in the world, that's nothing. There's greater, severe punishments after that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave people time, gave them respite, gave them warning, sent Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. And likewise as well, not necessarily utilizing the stick and punishing the child. Primarily, a parent, a teacher needs to identify the situation, see what is required. So there is Islah, there is reformation. So if we study Quran as well, when those severe punishments came, after warning upon warning, after reminder upon reminder, after exhausting avenues so that these people could realize their folly and their flaws, the final nail in the coffin came. And that was a severe punishment. And it was a lesson for people after that as well. So the people of Lut, their punishment compared to every other punishment, this was like a multiple punishment to show the severity of that. So Shaitan has to destroy any nation, then this is a factor which he'll want to make vogue. And before the coming of Dajjal, the lesbianism, homosexuality, transgenderism, the transgender lifestyle, transgender agenda will be highlighted. LGBT, the ideology and the concept will be promoted. And the strategies which Batil have implemented, obviously through the guidance of Iblis, One is they will talk about it as much as possible. They will promote it so it will become desensitized. It will seem normal. It will become like the mainstream. They will have school queer days. They will have open days where you can say that, na'udhu billah, this is my agenda. And you are part of the agenda now. And they will promote it, whether it's in television, and in books, in musicals, in wherever form. They will make their superheroes gay. They will make Bollywood and Hollywood stars do X on television to promote it to be normal. Na'udhu billah. Then, number two, they will portray these people as victims. So do not, like a non-bully campaign, these people are oppressed. Number three, they will justify. They will say that, you know what, we want equality. We want to protect people's rights. We want diversity. We don't want discrimination. We want liberty and equality. In the name of that, they will promote this agenda. Then they will make the victimizer. So any alim, any scholar, any madrasa, any darul ulum, any institute that speaks bad about this year, they will make them look bad. They are old school, they are outdated, and they will give them different and fancy names. So they will want to create a culture of silence that anybody who speaks against it, they are the oppressors, na'udhu billah, and they are intolerant. And then lastly, they will create a system of legality where they will legalize these forms of disobedience. And previously we will see, go back in history, in many countries, yeah, these crimes were punishable. It was criminal activity. Now they've legalized it. So we have to be very cautious of the agendas which are out there. And part of that is when this mindset comes, then eventually your children are at risk, themselves personally at risk, and by predators as well. As many as 93% of victims under the age of 18 generally know the abuser. They know the abuser, and 8 out of 10 perpetrators does not necessarily have to be an adult to harm the child. So many a time they have a relationship with the child, whether it's an older sibling, whether it's a playmate, a friend, a family member, a teacher, a coach, an instructor, a caretaker, a parent of another child. So these abusers manipulate the victims and they use different tactics, and they will use their position of power over a victim to coerce, to intimidate the child, to force the child to do and to comply. Sometimes they may use another strategy to encourage the child to say it is normal and you should be part of it and you can enjoy it. Sometimes they use threats, etc., so that they can violate the innocence of the child. So some signs of abuse, topics, excessive talk with regards to sexual behavior is a red light. The child keeping secrets or not talking as much, not wanting to be left alone with certain people, being afraid of certain caregivers. Regressive behavior or resuming behavior, thumb sucking, bed wetting, etc. Maybe overly compliant behavior because of fear. Certain behaviors which are inappropriate for the child's age. Spending a lot of time alone because they've been they've had access to this information. And they think and they deem it to be an activity. So they will be spending a lot of time, whether it's in the bathroom, in the shower, etc. Being afraid of removing the clothing, changing, bathing, etc. Then emotional signs, change of eating habits, change in mood, personality, increased aggression, decrease in confidence or self-image, excess worry, fearfulness, increased unexplained health problems, stomach aches, headaches, etc., loss or decrease in interest in activities, in friends, nightmares, fear of being alone, self-harming behaviors. So we have to be cautious of adults, of people who spend time with children, and have certain behaviors as well. So look at the red markers. Do they not respect the boundaries when they are told? They you give them instructions and they don't follow it. The child try to be the child's friend. They fill the role of the child's life. They don't have age-appropriate relationships. Talks with the children about personal problems. Make them their friends. Spends time alone with the child and makes excuses to be alone with the child, wants to take the child alone, goes to areas, etc. Gives the child gifts without any necessary justification. Spends a lot of time with the child, restricts the child's access to other adults. So many a child, one youngster explains that it was my father's friend and our neighbor, and he used to invite me a lot, give me a lot of sweets and chocolates, and that's where it all went wrong. Somebody explains he was my maternal uncle, and I met him 1,000 times, but that's where the abuse starts. Somebody said I was 8 years old, and it was my cousin. So nowadays there is a proliferation of these agendas from the internet to television, to movies, to porn sites, etc. To such an extent, Allah protect us. Increase in incest has become rife recently. So father-in-law abusing the daughter-in-law, our girls going out in the workplaces and becoming abused, where they even spike the drinks, give them drugs and make them addicts and use as drugs to control them. Brothers abusing sisters, brothers-in-laws abusing sister-in-laws, young girls, boys left alone with the workers, domestic workers, etc. So Hurmate Musaaharah is where a male touches a female who is 9 years of age or more with lust without any veil in between. The wife becomes haram. So this Hurmate Musaaharah becomes established, and not only your wife, but ascendants and descendants of both people involved become haram. There are serious implications with regards to this. So we have to be very careful and cautious. So this is a chapter which could go on, but it's been highlighted because it's becoming vogue, it's becoming rife, it's been promoted, and they're creating the mindset of being apologetic. So you said a statement, you're homophobic, na'uzubillah. Allah and His Rasul's laws are clear cut, black and white. These are our rules. So how, like you are saying, you got the right to do what you want to and you should be respected. We also have a right to do what we want to and we also should be respected. So how come we should respect your views, but you cannot respect our views? So if you feel that you've got a doubt in your gender and you want to go beyond human nature and you feel that is that, that's your problem. But I have a right to believe you are wrong and this is how it should be. So you respect me, I will respect you in that sense. So why is it one-sided? Why we should we feel bad, etc.? So the people of Iman need to speak about it. You need to tell your children about it. You need to be crystal clear. You need to spell it out. They watching more harmful, more disastrous, more dangerous things which you've given them access to. But we shy to be clear and concise. So protecting your children is important. And this is a great fitna which is on our doorstep. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect one in all. The amal for today is that to make wudu properly, if we can make a fresh wudu, to remain all the time in wudu, it is very important. إِنَّ أُمَّتِي يُدْعَوْنَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ غُرًّا مُحَجَّلِينَ مِنْ آثَارِ الْوُضُوءِ, that my ummah will be called on the day of Qiyamah, and their foreheads, their limbs will be bright and shining due to the effects of wudu. فَمَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمْ أَن يُطِيلَ غُرَّتَهُ فَلْيَفْعَلْ, so whoever has the potential to lengthen their whiteness, then they should do that as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.